Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hello, sorry about the absence, but so I died a bunch of times. I was trying to get power within for this fight, but the reality is that it's not like this fight is just gonna be patience and being careful not to let her surround me in fire and be careful with the explosion because that has fucked me over so many times now. Like right now, I should just leave, for example. That's not a good time to do that. My ideas disappeared. Man, the poison lasts for so long. Yeah, because if you are up in her balls, she doesn't, like she keeps on doing melee, which is actually pretty good. That's kind of bullshit attack, but that's okay. Right, there you go. Yeah, I have no. I guess I need to be careful not to be trapped on her side. Cause if I get trapped on her side, she like that's another it happened before too, like she just does the explosion, the explosion is a one shot, one kill. I could try and tank him with my shield, but that's so risky. I guess next time I can try it. Better than yeah. I kinda want to do as many, just for fun, I want to do as many bosses with Pyromancy. But at this point I'm getting really tempted to just get the Drake Sword and kinda speed this up. Not that the Drake Sword makes it incredibly easier, but it makes it easier than 20 damage. You know I'm actually just do that. Wow. That was a lot of damage. Yeah, I'll do that. I'll go offline with the mic again, but I'll go up, get the Drake Sword. On the way, I'm trying to get that fucking what's it called? Firekeeper Soul. I'm trying to get it so that I get 2 plus 1 and I can get the one in New Londo and I can get 2 plus 2 from the beginning, which is good. Plus 2 is all you need for a soul level 1. I don't need it, I guess, so I wouldn't waste time doing that. Yeah, I should have gotten the great sword, the Drake sword immediately. I don't know why I tried to get a Blight Tongue, because I mean, the when I was taking notes about it, the idea was to use Mildred, but then I decided that I don't want to use any companion to do the bosses. So. Well, let's go get us a Drake sword, and we'll see how that fight is. I'll be back with the mic in a few. Well, I just discovered that I got royally owned by the game. Because I totally cannot use the Drake Sword. Huh. Wait, is the fact that I cannot use it, it still does damage? It seems so, like it still does... Who knows, it's super heavy, but that's not a problem. Still does plenty of critical damage. God, I wonder if I do more damage with the Drake Sword, even though I cannot wield it, than I do with the axe. I guess it's worth a try, but man, totally owned. Totally owned. I thought I could... I thought I could totally use the Drake Sword, but nope. Onage, that's okay. Does he have club? I will reinforce club. I can, that I know. Does he have a battle axe? Because I actually kind of like the battle axe a lot. No, he doesn't. Okay, I'll get the reinforced club actually, which is a soul level 1 weapon. And let's get the short bow. And let's get these arrows, and that's it.
Hey! What?
Oh, what's the matter with you? I bought a bunch of stuff. Okay, let's try Quelaag with this. It's pretty funny if even though I cannot wield it, I do more damage than my shitty hand axe. Wow, totally owned. You have 9 dex as a soul level 1. I thought you had 10. I guess the reinforced club is still good though, because it's 97 and it scales with strength, which means that if I two-hand it, I do more damage than the axe. So that's better than nothing. But I really was hoping for the 200 physical of the Drake Sword. Well, we are back at Quelaag. That's gonna unlock the run. Like, once I do Quelaag, everything else is done. Not that it's gonna be necessarily easy, but at least it won't be as long of a fight as Quelaag is gonna be. So, just hang in there. It's just gonna be that one. I'll be back with the mic in a few, but I'll probably just kind of run Quelaag until I do it. Bye.